Well, greetings and welcome to our special service of 9 lessons and carols here in the Longford Group of Parishes. Wherever you're joining us from, you're most welcome. For those who do not know me, my name is Reverend Simon Scott, the minister in charge of this Longford Group. And I welcome you on behalf of the parishioners and of all of us in fellowship. The service of 9 lessons and carols is a most magical service of readings that bring us through the narrative of the Gospels, the narrative of the Scriptures, from beginning to end, reminding us of the joy of Jesus in our lives. We have here beside us the Advent wreath, all lit, and the candles remind us of the light of God in the world. So as you join us, enjoy every moment. No doubt you're peeling the potatoes and the carrots, ready for Christmas dinner too. Wherever you're doing, enjoy with us, sing along, partake, and follow the majesty of God in the readings and in the presentations of music. Our greeting, the Lord be with you and also with you. The bidding, the people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given. His name will be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. The joy of this service is there are so many people involved. Some of our children, some of our parishioners, and some from neighbouring parishes are sending greetings and delight in this season with us. Thank you to everyone who's been part of it, both on camera and behind the scenes, and enjoy every moment. As we open, may I hand you over to two of my colleagues, Reverend Christian Snell of the Methodist Church and the Church of Ireland Group in Edwardstown, and to Father Turlock Baxter, the parish priest in Killeshie, who open our service.
Hello to you all in the Longford Group of Parishes. As you enjoy your Christmas carol service this year, I want to send you greetings from Longford Methodist Church to wish you all a happy and merry Christmas and God's blessing for the year 2021. As everybody has been saying, this Christmas will be different for us in that we will not be able to celebrate it in the way that we are familiar with. And the question I've been thinking about for this Christmas in our churches is how can we have joy even in the midst of COVID-19? My thoughts returned to the letter that Peter writes to the believers who are scattered throughout the world. And Peter reminds them that they do have an inexpressible and a glorious joy in spite of the trials and the troubles that they are going through. And that is a wonderful message for us to hold on to, that we can have joy this Christmas as we think about the gift that God has given us, new life in Him, mercy, and God's precious Son, the Lord Jesus, that He has given to us as a gift. And as we fix our eyes on Jesus, I pray that we will be filled with His joy this Christmas. But Peter also reminds us that we can have joy this Christmas time as we remember that God is working in us and through us even in these difficult times. He is making us long more for Christ and His coming. And so that is how we can have joy this Christmas, as we look forward to Christ and His appearing. Even though we don't see Him now, Peter says, we believe in Him and we are filled with an inexpressible and a glorious joy. And I pray that you and your families will know that joy this Christmas as we celebrate the coming of our Lord Jesus, our Saviour and our Lord. So I wish you a happy Christmas from everyone in Longford Methodist Church, including those here in the manse on the Battery Road. God bless.
Greetings from Killeshie. Father Turlock Baxter here, a native of Longford Town, but living here in Killeshie, it's good to join with the Longford Union of Parishes as we begin the 9 lessons and carol service to celebrate this time of preparation for Christmas. This beautiful tradition in continuing to tell the story of Christmas over word and song. So often beginning with the carol Once in Royal David City and ending with the Gospel of St. John, the prologue of the Gospel that reminds us that the Lord is faithful to the Word. The Word became flesh and dwelt amongst us. God is faithful to his Word, and that Word, that promise of the Lord, is Jesus Christ. As we let the Lord enter into our lives in a special way this Christmas time, let us join in celebration to know the Lord is with us always.
Once in royal David City stood a lowly cattle shed, where a mother laid her baby in a manger for his bed. Mary was that mother mild, Jesus Christ a little child. He came down to earth from heaven, who is God and Lord of all, and his shelter was a stable, and his cradle was a stall, with the poor and mean and lowly lived on earth a Saviour holy. And through all his wondrous childhood he would honour and obey, love and watch the lowly maiden in whose gentle arms he lay. Christian children all must be mild, obedient, good as he. For he is a childhood pattern, day by day like us he grew. He was little, weak and helpless, tears and smiles like us he knew. And he feeleth for our sadness, and he shareth in our gladness. And our eyes at last shall see him through his own redeeming love. For that child, so dear and gentle, is our Lord in heaven above. And he leads his children home to the place where he is gone. Not in that poor lowly stable with the oxen standing by, we shall see him but in heaven, set at God's right hand on high. When like stars his children proud, all in white shall wait around.
This is a reading from Genesis chapter 3, verses 8 to 15. That evening they heard the Lord God walking in the garden, and they hid from him among the trees. But the Lord called out to the man, "Where are you?" He answered, "I heard you in the garden. I was afraid and hid from you because I was naked." "Who told you that you were naked?" God asked. "Did you eat the fruit that I told you not to eat?" The man answered, "The woman you put here with me gave me the fruit, and I ate it." The Lord God asked the woman, "Why did you do this?" She replied, "The snake tricked me into eating it." Then the Lord said to the snake, "You will be punished for this. You alone of all animals must bear this curse. From now on, you will crawl on your belly, and you will have to eat dust as long as you live. I will make you and the woman hate each other. Her offspring and yours will always be enemies. Her offspring will crush your head, and you will bite her offspring's heel."
My reading is taken from Genesis 22, 12 to 18. Genesis 22, 12 to 18 from the New International Version. Do not lay a hand on the boy, he said. Do not do anything to him. Now I know that you fear God because you have not withheld from me your son, your only son. Abraham looked up, and there in the thicket he saw a ram caught by its horns. He went over and took the ram and sacrificed it as a burnt offering instead of his son. So Abraham called that place, "The Lord will provide." And to this day it is said, "On the mountain of the Lord it will be provided." The angel of the Lord called to Abraham from heaven a second time and said, "I swear by myself, declares the Lord, that because you have done this and have not withheld your son, your only son, I will surely bless you and make your descendants as numerous as the stars in the sky and as the sand on the seashore. Your descendants will take possessions of the cities of their enemies, and through your offspring, all nations on earth will be blessed because you have obeyed me." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Amen.
It's an unusual Christmas with everybody isolating, and people may be feeling there's very little joy. But there is, because it's somebody's birthday. Crackers and turkeys and puddings and cream, toys in the window that I've never seen. This is the Christmas that everyone sees, but Christmas means more to me. It's somebody's birthday, I won't forget. As I open the things that I get, I remember the inn and this table so bare, and Jesus who once lay there. Everyone's out shopping late every night for candles and presents and Christmas tree lights. This is the Christmas that everyone sees, but Christmas means more to me. It's somebody's birthday, I won't forget. As I open the things that I get, I remember the inn and the stable so bare, and Jesus who once lay there. Christmas morning, the start of the day, there's presents to open and new games to play. This is the Christmas that everyone sees, but Christmas means more to me. It's somebody's birthday, I won't forget. As I open the things that I get, I remember the inn and the stable so bare, and Jesus who once lay there. I'll remember the inn and the stable so bare, and Jesus who once lay there.
Isaiah chapter 9, verses 2 to 7. For to us a child is born. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwelt in a land of deep darkness, on them has light shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you, as with joy at the harvest, as they are glad when they divide their spoil. For the yoke of his burden, and the staff for his shoulder, the rod of his oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For every boot of the tramping warrior in battle tumult, and every garment rolled in blood, will be burned as fuel for the fire. For to us a child is born, To us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and of peace there will be no end. On the throne of David and over his kingdom, to establish it and to uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time forth and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this.
A reading from Isaiah chapter 11, beginning at verse 1. The royal line of David is like a tree that's been cut down, but just as new branches sprout from a stump, so a new king will arise among David's descendants. The Spirit of the Lord will give him wisdom and the knowledge and skill to rule his people. He will know the Lord's will and honor him, and find pleasure in obeying him. He will not judge by appearance or hearsay. He will judge the poor fairly and defend the right to the helpless. At his command, the people will be punished, and evil persons will die. He will rule his people with justice and integrity. Wolves and sheep will live together in peace, and leopards will lie down with young goats. Calves and lion cubs will feed together, and little children will take care of them. Cows and bears will eat together, and their calves and cubs will lie down in peace. Lions will eat straw as cattle do. Even a baby will not be harmed if it plays near a poisonous snake. On Zion, God's sacred hill, there will be nothing harmful or evil. The land will be as full of knowledge of the Lord as the seas are full of water. Here ends the reading.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy will one day walk on water? Did you know that your baby boy will save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you've delivered will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to the blind man? Did you know that your baby boy will calm the storm in his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? And when you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. Mary, did you know? See, the deaf will hear, the dead will live again, the lame will leap, the dumb will speak the praises of the Lamb. Mary, did you know? Mary, did you know that your baby boy is Lord of all creation? Did you know that your baby boy will one day rule the nations? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? Sleeping child you're holding is the great I am. Mary, did you know?
Reading from Luke chapter 1, beginning at verse 26. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and the angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel, "since I am a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age. And she, who was said to be barren, is in her sixth month. For no word from God will ever fail." "I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May your word to me be fulfilled." Then the angel left.
Luke chapter 2 verses 1 to 7, the birth of Jesus Christ. In those days a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration when Quirinius was governor of Syria, and all went to be registered, each to his own town. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to give birth. And she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling cloths, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
Chapter 2, verses 8 to 20, the shepherds and the angels. There were some shepherds in the parish of the country who were spending the night in the fields, taking care of their flocks. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone over them. They were terribly afraid, but the angel said to them, "Don't be afraid, I am here with good news for you, which will bring great joy to all the people. This very day in David's town your Saviour was born, Christ the Lord, and this is what will prove it to you. You will find a baby wrapped in strips of cloth and lying in a manger." Suddenly a great army of heaven's angels appeared with the angel, singing praises to God. "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and peace on earth to those whom he is pleased." When the angels went away from them back into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us. So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and saw the baby lying in the manger. When the shepherds saw him, they told them what the angel had said about the child. All who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said. Mary remembered all these things and thought deeply about them. The shepherds went back, saying praises to God for all they had heard and seen. It had been just as the angel had told them.
Great news! Come on!
Christmas time, we celebrate the greatest gift the world could ever receive, Jesus in a manger. The joy of the season is to remind us that Jesus is here with us. And all our readings through Scripture that you've heard testify to God's faithful presence with his people. Jesus is a special gift in each of our lives that, by his grace, allow us to come into the company of God. Allow us to experience his love, his fellowship, and delight in his company. Jesus is the gift. And as the king of the world, he received three gifts from the wise men. Do you remember what they are? Gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Three gifts that as a baby hinted at his life. The gift of gold. Gold for the king that he was. Frankincense. For the priest that he was, bringing repentance for all his people. And myrrh, the embalming fluid, hinting at his death and resurrection. Jesus is our King. He is the greatest gift we can all experience. All we need to say is, Lord Jesus, I'm here. I receive your gift. You're my King. And he will share his salvation with us.
Guys, I hope you're having a blessed Christmas. and that you can really feel the presence of the Lord this Advent. And I also hope that you get to spend some time with friends and family over this period too. Today's reading is taken from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 2, verses 1 to 12. Now, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he who has been born king of the Jews? For we saw his star when it rose, and have come to worship him." When Herod the king heard this, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And assembling all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it is written by the prophet, 'And you, O Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel.' Then Herod summoned the wise men secretly and ascertained from them what time the star had appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, 'Go and search diligently for the child. And when you have found him, bring me word, that I too may come and worship him.' After listening to the king, they went out on their way. And behold, the star that they had seen when it rose went before them until it came to rest over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced exceedingly with great joy. And going into the house, they saw the child with Mary his mother, and they fell down and worshipped him. Then, opening their treasures, they offered him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh. And being warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed to their own country by another way." This is the word of the Lord. God bless you guys.
Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all ye nations rise, join the triumph of the skies. With angelic hosts proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Christ by highest heaven adored, Christ the everlasting Lord, late in time behold him come, offspring of a virgin's womb. Veiled in flesh the Godhead see, hail the incarnate deity. Pleased is man with man to dwell, Jesus our Emmanuel. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Hail the heaven-born Prince of Peace, hail the Son of Righteousness. Life and life to all he brings, risen with healing in his wings. Mild he lays his glory by, born that man no more may die. Born to raise the sons of earth, born to give them second birth. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King.
John chapter 1, verses 1 to 14. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light, so that through him all might believe. He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light. The true light that gives light to everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who did receive him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become the children of God. Children born of this natural descent, nor of human decision or husband's will, but born of God. The world became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the only, one and only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is a night of a dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, oh, hear the angel voices.
Fall on your knees.
Let us bless the living God. He was born of the Virgin Mary, revealed in his glory, worshipped by angels, proclaimed among the nations, believed in throughout the world, exalted to the highest heavens. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and all your family this Christmas time. Amen. God bless and happy Christmas, and we will see you soon.